So welcome to a video about Gundams. Welcome to Gundam Hunt. After a long absence of 1 or 2 years, I'm back from depression and back on the saddle of the horse. This is Lita Hobby Shop. It's in a mall, a new mall that has been open for 3 months only, and I already forgotten what's the name of the mall, but never mind, who cares. So there is a big poster of the Barbados or something, I'm not sure. It's from the Iron Blooded Orphans anime, which I did not follow at all. I watched only 2 or 3 episodes and I stopped watching it because reasons. I don't care about it. So wow, there's a huge big RX-78-2. I think it's a worker style or maybe a real great, because of the color separation. It's grey. It's got two tones of grey you can see there, and also a white. Yeah, but I think there's a lot of dust on it, so shit, they should like wipe it down, you know. Dust is made out of humans, right? It's human skin, that is. So very awesome indeed, this huge worker style, if I'm not mistaken. Or real great style, who knows? Who cares actually? Who fucking cares? But nice, I like it, it's huge. All like a girl, I do like huge things, including penises. So next, yeah, this one here is the Grim Girder Iron Blooded Orphans High Grade. I hate high grade, so I should not cover them, but never mind. Zaku 2, big gun set, nice. Millennium Falcon don't give a shit anymore, thanks to George Lucas's prequels. Ooh, fucking hell, this is a huge kit. This is actually a high grade. The Dendrobium thingy, I think. I'm not sure what's the whole unit called, but it comes in a very big box and you have to assemble it, and if it looks like this, then it looks very very awesome indeed. Very very awesome, I like it. It's huge, like my dick. 8 inches of my dick. And coincidentally, I watched a JAV, Japanese adult video, involving a girl that I like, and she was fucked by a black dude who has a 10 inch dick. Oh my god, I never seen a dick that long before. Holy fucking moly, thank god it was like Japanese porn, pixelated. I would not be able to stand the sheer amount and virosity, or the what you call, super awesomeness of such a long big dick, which is just 2 inches longer than my 8-inch dick. So this, there are some claws here grabbing on to a lightsaber or a beam saber, but that beam saber seems to be a bit too big for that high grade dendrobium, I think, to hold on to with his regular fingers. So it's weird that this thing is so huge compared to that. You know, it's just like the Gundam there, which you might think is a small little child of 5 years old, and you asked the child to hold your dick. It's something similar to this big lightsaber, and I should not have made that comparison because that's very vulgar. So next up, this is high grade, the Neo Zeon, huge and very huge. No dick, thank god. Never mind. And it has been, I think, matte finished. It's not shiny. So matte finish, either that or it has a layer of dust, so I'm not sure which one, but I think it's the matte finishing that makes it less shiny and less plasticky. I'm talking like a madman because the music is quite loud, so shit. Besides having all these snapped-on kits, they have the previous Gunpla winners from Malaysia. This is the Neo Zeon or whatever, I'm not sure, who knows. So these are the back sides of the kits. Forgot what's the name of the winners. We have the gold here, blah blah blah. And others. The Fanny's up there and the Destiny up there, Bill Fighter version. Don't give a shit. But this one here is nice because it uses the Kasatria wings and it turns into a dragon. And there's another unicorn-like half beast, half humanoid up there. Is no idea, can't see from there, but it uses the Kasatria stuff, the binders as they call it. So let's go in and take a looky. Hiya, you like Gundams as well?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'm making a video about Gundams. What's your name?
Yu Zhong.
Sorry?
Yu Zhong.
Yu Zhong, do you do all these customizing or just
I just buy and build.
Oh, buy and build. Oh, okay, okay, cool. See you later.
See you.
So let's see here. Free gift for entering the place? No, I don't think so. Hey, bosses, how you ying da mo ah? Ying da mo ah? Can I? Can. Thanks. Okay, there's a representative from Litak. So let's see here. The unicorn perfect grade. Too bad it's not the Banshee. Let's see here, the RE Reborn 100 DJ. The one RE 100s, even though the perfect grade, I mean the inner frame is not so elaborate, but it's better than nothing. Sorry? 50%?
40%.
How much is that? Your Litak.
This one,
Litak is expensive.
This one is 100 plus.
Oh, okay.
40%
discount. Oh, this one is
100%?
100% discount?
Yeah,
40%. 100% discount where? 100%
agreement.
Oh, okay.
So,
all 40%. Yeah. Oh, okay, 40%. But then again, the Litak is actually very expensive. Which is bullshit. So, 227, 40% is about 110 ringgit. So, 110 ringgit for this Reborn here. And if you were to apply the 40% to this 1,400 ringgit, it will roughly be about 600 ringgit. So still, never mind, fuck it. If you were to convert it to yen, which is stated here, 200 yen times, I think 4, becomes 800. So 600 versus 800. So it's quite cheap, not bad, if you like original stuff. So the reason why I was here is because I was going through the Laoyat forum, and of course the Laoyat forum is discussing Chinese Gundams or pirated Gundams, third party Gundams and knockoff Gundams, and they made a video of this place. So I was curious and found out that it's in a mall which I forgot the name of. What's this mall's name? Fucking knows, I don't care. So it was quite near PJ, so that's why it took me 20 minutes or less just to come here. With the help of the Google Maps, and also if I was lost, I can use my smartphone, which is also quite new, which I never had a smartphone before. Yes, smartphones are quite awesome, and I have to get the app that actually helps guys like me to fuck girls who don't need a lot of convincing to be let fucked. I think there's an app there, so I should ask my friend Hans for those apps, because it's not always nice to have a fuck sometimes without, I mean, paying for dinner and that's all, and fuck. Oh, and also have to pay for the hotel, unfortunately. Can't bring them back home to my house because I don't want my family members to see me fucking somebody else. I should not be talking about that. So this thing here is not panel lined, so no decals too. So it's vanilla, so it can be even better looking if you were to apply your Gundam marker on it. So 672 bucks for this Gundam Barbados with the gold frame, if I'm not mistaken, and a lot of people have said it's not worth it, the kit that is. So you might as well buy the normal one, which is much, much cheaper. So lovely indeed, these winners of the, you can see the Jetstar here, which is quite small, even though in high grades, I think it's high grade, I'm not sure, but it's very small. I don't think it's high grade, it's something else. So there's a Kassatra that has a very huge unicorn head, or horn, unicorn horn. Weird indeed. Very weird. But never mind, it looks awesome indeed. Awesome indeed. This one, I think I've seen this before, maybe in Infinite Creation Workshop in somewhere in Petaling Jaya. Yeah, looks awesome. So who's the creator? I forgot already. There's no sign that says or indicates who created this thing or who made this thing. So very awesome indeed. Dragons, lots of dragons. Game of Thrones episode 9 came out about a couple of days ago, specifically 4 or 5 days ago on Sunday. The Battle of the Fucking Bastards. Let's see here. Oh, this is quite cool actually. This is the dorm in the middle, all battle scarred, and I can see that there is a, the reflection is bad, Shah Aznable there. Interesting. There's a Master Grade Zaku 2 there as well. Very cool indeed, very cool. Oh, this is a junior. 15 years old. Can it be? Wow, so much potential. If only it was a female. That would be every Gunpla builder's wet dream. So this is a new Zhong Master Grade with legs. Oof, it's gonna be huge. Huge indeed, very huge, very huge. That's what I would like her to say. That's what she said, huge, very huge. So this is a yellow unit using the O Gundam, so Master Grade I think, size. Cool indeed, and the humanoids are quite big. This is a Gundam wing, of course, with a ball for a vagina or a groin. Nice, and that one is quite nice. Zaku 2, 148 skill. Not a perfect grade, I think. It's a 148 skill because 148 skills are, I think, it's cheaper. It's quite cheap for its size. And up there is the Astray Song Goku, I think. And also the Destiny Build Fighter version. Is it? No idea. So besides that, oh, real great. Oh, this is a new one, the Cunt. The real great Cunt. The next one, the next in line will be the Sinanju. Not sure when it's going to come out, but it looks awesome indeed because of the gold runners. You have to bear in mind that this Cunt here, the left arm is different from the right arm. It's different. One has blue, the other one is has white, and one shoulder armor is longer than the other one because this shield bits here, or the sword thingy, is on one side. So I had the pleasure or the chance to actually purchase this from Daban model, but that's the Master Grade, not the real grade. But I've done the Master Grade 00 Riser and also the Seven Swords. Of course, that's from Daban models, of course, cheaper. And I think if I were to purchase the Master Grade of this Cunt here, and definitely I'll be a cunt because it's going to be the same old shit all over again. The frame is the same, everything's the same, and the only difference that I can see is the thigh part there. You can see the thigh, there's an opening when the knee or the leg is bent. You can see the separation of the armor, of the thigh armor. Cool, very cool indeed. Normally you won't find any of these separation, the armor separation in regards to the 00 frame. So what else do they have? Nice, all of these Master Grades. Lovely. All the RX-78-2s, all of them different. Which one is the origin? I'm not sure. The movie origin, that is. Ah, yes, I can see that's the fucker there. Because of the yellow blaster on the right shoulder, right side shoulder, and also of course the Predator style gun on his left shoulder. Very nice indeed, the origin. Not the OVAs, aka the movies. I only like the first movie. The second and third one is quite a letdown because of lack of mech battles. This one here, I think it's a worker, or is it the 3.0? I think it's the Master Grade 3.0. Looks great indeed, all types of ways of deckling it, and also to panel line it. Lots of nooks and crannies to fill with your Gundam marker. Very nice indeed. So that one here is the 00 Riser. I'm not curious about it because I rebuilt it. But here is a shot of it. What I haven't built is this Freedom, Strike Freedom. I would love to own perfect grade, but I think building the wings at the back there, it would be very, very boring indeed. Very boring. At least the gold in this is not the cute gold or the subdued gold or the matte gold. This is the silver gold, which is much, much desired. This is the full, what the fuck is this? Shin Asuka's unit. I forgot what's the name. I don't like Shin Asuka from the Destiny Gundam series. Then this is the... Actually, it's quite nice, the Axia. The design of Axia is very nice. And especially the coating for this sword. I like the coating. Lovely, lovely. At the back there, of course, it's a very nice looking Hainu Gundam. It's, I think it's special. I think it's metal, metallic based. It's very shiny. Is it a special master grade? I'm not sure. But it's very shiny, you can see that it's almost as if it's enamel. Enamel, sorry, not animal. My pronunciation is terrible. I like this one. The Justice, Infinite Justice Master Grade. Looks awesome. And of course there's a Destiny there. Don't buy the Destiny from TT Home Lee, it sucks. Even the full burst mode sucks. Balls, what the fuck? Hopefully this shop, I mean this building is not gonna crash. This is the Master Grade World Car version of the Sasabi. Very nice, very nice. Yeah, all the bits are coming out or being separated from the body to reveal some of the awesome inner frame. Kinda maybe. Very nice. Lovely, lovely. I'm very interested in that Infinite Justice actually. But I don't fancy the beams coming out of the tip of the foot and also that is attached to the knee. This is the controversial Master Grade 2.0 Freedom. Looks awesome, you can deckle it. There's a lot of nooks and crannies to mark it with your Gundam marker. Looks very refined, very slim. A lot of design changes to the arms. Your arms can bend more and more. But the problem is, I do not like the front two blasters. This one here, it looks like a fan at the tip there, so it sucks. I don't like that design. It's not true to the anime at all. So, but still, it looks very nice actually, in hindsight. Very nice indeed. And of course, you can purchase through P Bandai or Premium Bandai the extra parts, the effect parts for all the blasters firing from the Gundam in rainbow colors, yellow, pink, orange, I think, not sure. But it looks nice, I really like it. Those are Master Grades, I'm not sure whether they have any more or not. These are the high grades. Oh, sorry, this is the real grades, I think. Wow, the real grades are very small. Very small and very detailed. Those are definitely not high grades. High grades are can't. I don't think it's that detailed. These are very detailed. Bear in mind it's very small. And you don't want your girlfriend to actually say that. Wow, I like this Infinite Justice. Nice. Strike, I'm really bored with doing the strike because I had the chance to build the perfect grade Strike Rouge with the Sky Grasper and the Ale Strike Pack courtesy of Model GD. Cost me 120 ringgit 2-3 years ago, which is equivalent to about $30 in today's money, today's currency exchange. They were having a closed down sale or bankrupt sale, so it's very cheap. I got it for very good, for a very good price. Very small, very small indeed. I like it. Very small. Ooh, I like this one, the Afrit. The Afrit Custom. Very nice. RE. And the DJ at the back. Is there construction happening somewhere else? I can feel somebody's banging the concrete. And that's the GPO 3, I think. RE. Oh, these are REs. Yeah. The Reborn series. Barbados. It's the inner frame of the Barbados. Iron Blooded Orphans thing. Inner frame. I don't know why they keep on saying that it might not be an inner frame, but it sure looks like an inner frame. The one from the Iron Blooded Orphans. The Gamrios at the back there, looking like a knight, and huge too, very bulky, it reminds me of the Zakus. Very nice, very nice. Oof. So what else is there? Oh, SD Gundams, super deformed ones, don't care. This one here is perfect grade. Ooh. Perfect grade. Very big. Are you sure? I think it's 148 scale. It's really huge. 148 scale, I think. I don't see any shield, any silver pistons inside, so definitely it's 148 scale. Yeah, yeah, and look at the fingers, the hands, it's only like one piece. So, it fooled me once, shame on me, fooled me twice, fuck my ass. So, yep, very nice. 148 scale. No interest. Evangelion was interested long time ago. This sucks. Anime was not so good. This one is the high grade. No, I'm still waiting for the bloody master grade of this. Actually, even are you sure it's high grade? I don't think so. Oh, this one is Zeta. This one is supposed to be 1/100 scale. There's no master grade for this. Definitely. So are you gonna buy any?
No.
No. Okay.
Just know that there is a shop here, so just come for.
Oh, okay. Okay. You're not from Meetup, right?
Pardon?
You're not from Meetup, right?
I don't know from Meetup.
Oh, okay. Right. More expensive one compared to the other hobby shops.
But this one, sort of.
Unless they have sale, then it's okay.
Sale also depends.
It's
main place.
Yeah, Chiraz there, right? Near Chiraz.
There was an exhibition recently in June, early June, at main place.
The Kilang, the
no,
officer.
No, Kilang. At main place here, USJ 21. There's a. It's a not exhibition, it's something like a gunplant display. Something like this, they display over there.
Okay.
Then the next one should be in.
Their officer.
December.
Yeah.
Office also okay, but depends on product.
Yeah.
You need to really go around.
Okay, okay.
Normally, what I do is I just look at this figure here.
Mm-hmm. Look at the yen.
Yen, you divide by 30, then there should be roughly the price. The reasonable price.
It's not 4.
Not 4,
divided
by 30.
No, I mean, let's see. $1 is equivalent to 4 ringgit.
This
so,
is yen.
100 yen is equivalent to how 4 ringgit?
100 yen is equivalent to
3 ringgit.
3 ringgit 33 cents.
Oh, US is much higher
not
than.
Exactly 3.33 is low, it's more than that. You need maybe 3.60 something, but easy side, I just divide by 3. 30. So 4,800 divided by 30 is 160. So 160 should be the reasonable price that you can get at Gamers Arena.
Gamers Arena.
You know.
Yeah, yeah. Berjaya Times Square. Is it the cheapest Gamers Arena?
They have a cheaper one. If I compare some online, some in Penang also quite okay on certain products.
Penang? Which one?
I can't recall the name.
Is it Bukit Jambu there?
No. It's online.
Oh, online.
I'm not sure whether they have a physical store or not.
Okay.
So
okay.
I just go there. I just search online at the time. I was looking for the Stardust Striker Pavsky ring.
Okay.
Not sure they heard of it before.
No, never heard of it.
Because there are a few versions, the one with a ring. You're into Gundam also?
What is it just now? What are you looking
Blue
for?
Fighter.
Blue Fighter, you mean the one with the.
Blue Fighter with wings.
Oh, the one, the three spiked wing. Yellow effect pass that one.
I think so, yes.
Okay.
There are two versions.
Nah, I don't like the Blue Fighters.
Looks okay sometimes. I like those with special guns mainly.
Okay.
A lot of characters. Especially the Strike Noir is quite nice.
Strike Noir? The one with the gun one.
With a
grey one, right?
Grey. Dark. Oh, it's black and white. And then there's.
The two revolvers, two guns.
Two guns.
With the wings at the back.
Wings at the back. That's very nice.
Then I think you should go for the third party one.
Dragon Momoko.
Dragon Momoko.
I'm not sure when is it coming, but it's really pre-ordered.
Yeah, it's out already. Where do you get your pre-orders from?
No. I didn't get mine. It's online.
Okay. Who is the best person to buy all this third party stuff? Like from TT, Daban Model and stuff?
Daban Model you can try, but not that cheap. I bought once actually from a guy in. I'm not sure they're recording or not, am I?
What? I'm recording?
Don't worry.
Okay.
Yes.
From where?
Yeah, from YouTube or what?
YouTube, yeah.
Okay.
Do you want me to record?
You better take it offline.
Oh, okay.
But he's recording the voice already, right?
Yeah. So I had a long chat with Mr. Chan there, who's a dapper looking insurance person from KL. So let's continue on doing the review of the displays here, and it's around 3:20 p.m. It's quite cold in here, which is good. And I already forgotten the name of the mall. Fuck, it's called Damao, I think. Not sure. Better drink a bit of water first. Oh, I haven't done a Gundam review or Gundam Hunt in a long time. I'm getting a bit rusty. The bad words and the dirty thoughts that comes out of my mouth is not that fluent. So Mr. Chu, or is it Mr. Chan? I forgot already. Shit, my memory is very bad. The short-term memory sucks balls. He's a member of the Toastmasters who is able to maybe talk you out of your panties. You were a girl. We had something in common, which we like to buy stuff or look for cheap Gundams from China. But of course, he complained that there were none in the Chow Kit area or Jalan Raja Laut. So I had to like tell him that sometimes there is and sometimes there is not. So, let's go on, continue on. That's Uji. I do not like this one at all. I'm not sure why the guys, the Hobby Link Japan guys from YouTube, Sid and Harry, I think, or Sid and somebody else, they like it. I do not. Here, the high grades, very small. And of course, my favorite design is the Easy 8. It got its name not because it's easy in spreading its legs because it's a guy, no, because it's just something similar to the name of a tank, a Sherman variant tank from World War II. Easy 8, and it wasn't white during the World War II, the Easy 8 tank, Sherman tank variant that is. There's a Zeta 22, Zeta 1, blah blah blah, and they're transformed versions or transformed stuff. This one, I have the high-grade Sasabi, definitely, from Tiki Hongli. There's a high-grade Hainu, high-grade Unicorn, and lovely high-grade Kasatria. And that person in Chow Kit or Jalan Raja Laut, one of the shops, I forgot what's the name, is called Something Toy, would not sell a Kasatria from Tiki Hongli cheaply to me. Some things I would give just for all these mechs. Okay, it's a TriStar. This is definitely the origin version of the TriStar with the sniper rifle and also the attachable bits on the shield. And yep, that's the origin goof, which I did not see at all in the second or third movie. And one of my other favorite designs is the Astray Mina Custom, which is, this one is the high grade. It's ugly as fuck because the gold is the puke gold. It's not a shiny gold, so too bad. Sucks. So there's other high grades here. Blah 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 blah. And there's a Bayerlin. Oh, sorry, that's the Bayerlin custom high grade, huge because it's very wide. It's similar. Oh, it's another one that I like. The Zaku 2. Oh, sorry, Zaku 1. Sniper. There's a Gyara Dogar and a Gyara Zuru. Wait, this one is something else. Fuck it. This one, the Dowen Wolf, high grade. I have the one, I just bought one. This is the Unicorn version. The one that I bought was the green version. This, that means it's the Universal Century version. So there are two versions to this high grade Dowen Wolf. Unicorn version, which is this one here, blue in color and has the sleeves, the black cuff sleeves and white sprue tree, I think. And the green one, which is the Unicorn, the Universal Century version. So two versions. And of course, in the Federation side, there's the Silver Bullet, same design, maybe two eyes instead of one. Bayern Custom is, I think it's a mono eye, but it's with the Federation, I'm not sure. This one here, I'm not sure what the hell it's called. Forgot what's the name, but it's awesome, of course, because it's a mono eye. Lovely. And would you get that in Master Grade form? Nope. Hopefully we'll make an appearance in the Reborn 100 series, which is we're pinning quite a number or a lot of our hopes on the Reborn series, because Mandai was a bit too lazy in designing the inner frame, so might as well slapdash one and just design the outer frame or the armor parts and give us an official Gundam or a mono eye that did not have 100 or 1 hour 100 scale release. There are so many kids that need the 1 hour 100 treatment. Not to say that the no grades are bad, but we need something from Bandai that's a bit more detailed in the armor department. So this is nice, they're simulating the Luke Skywalker's ejaculating into the hole to destroy the Death Star. And of course Darth Vader, soon to be father. And what do you call that? If you kill your father, it's called patricide. If you kill your unknown son, what is it called? Sunny side? I'm not talking about the eggs, sunny side. Ha 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 ha. One Piece, no interest in them at all. Bunny and Tiger, such a promising anime, especially in regards to the Pepsi girl. And these two guys couldn't even put their dicks into her. It's a stupid anime. Not sure why people like it. This one, however, the what you call 219999 Space Battle Yamato is an excellent anime, lovely. And one of the alien girls, I think she has purple skin, she is hot as fuck. And the Evangelion series. If you guys out there love Asuka, go ahead if you are a teenager. But I'm quite old already and it's quite creepy if I want to fuck Asuka. But then again, I really want to fuck Asuka, even though she's technically 15 years old. Evangelion 06 here, lovely. I have the perfect grade, Evangelion 01, and it's not that perfect. Definitely, because it's the first perfect grade from Bandai. These are from the movies. So far, there's movie 01, 02, and 03, if I'm not mistaken, or is it called something else? 3.0, 3.01, whatever. I don't know what the fuck is wrong with Hideaki Anno, the director, but I think I prefer him being depressed. Depression gets the best out of creative people. He's happy now with her family and maybe with one daughter. And the Evangelion movies are awesome, of course. Technically, very nice to look at, but substance-wise, it's like a beautiful girl. Might be pretty outside, but inside might be empty, which is, a lot of guys would love that. A wife who behaves and follows the patriarch's orders. Nice. Evangelion, ooh, that one is nice too. I wonder if it's all plastic or is there a gimp suit, a black leather gimp suit that goes over the inner frame. That one I do not like at all because that sucks balls. Whoa, this is the movie version of Eva 02 with the head, which is kind of like one eye gone. Quite awesome indeed. I've never seen these boxes before. Very nice. Very nice. And you can get it from Litak, of course. Litak is the official distributor of Bandai products. And this one is very old actually. Very old. Not sure why. Have I ever seen him before? I don't remember. Is it from the movie 3-0? I think so. I don't really care about Evangelion. Don't really care about it. Let's see here. Besides all these kits here, you have the stand, the accessories for the hands, the extra weapon bits and whatnot. And you can get it here, definitely. And of course, I think it was very expensive LED units, the Perfect Great Unicorn LED units. If I'm not mistaken, it's the same price as the fucking Perfect Great Unicorn. I'm not sure. It's because of the engineering that went into this, R&D, that's why it's so bloody fucking expensive. Holy shit. 840 ringgit. I wonder how much was the Perfect Grade. But this is actually new engineering, that's why it's expensive. You know the Japanese, you know, the engineers stuff and the whole world will follow suit. Yep, anime has taken over, lolitas are the trend now, so keep your daughters who are 15 years and younger away from the outside world. So scary, scary world that we live in nowadays. And of course, I think they created the dildo that can vibrate. Excellent. Excellence. And that's what the women were crying out, moaning out, saying that they are blessed with such a contraption, such as the dildo that vibrates with AA batteries. Or was it single A battery? No. The the name of this that I want to is, what is it called? Yes, now I remember, it's called masala. Yes, M-A-S-A-L-A, masala. Because I remember garam masala is a spice that you need to use for a certain curry dishes. Yep, masala. And in Malay, masala means problem or difficulty. And I like the sniper. I wish there was a Master Grade version of the Zaku 1 sniper. There's also the Zagok, thanks to the what you call unicorn movie or unicorn OVA. Looks awesome indeed. They must design a Master Grade for this. I like the Shroom Gallows too. Shroom Gallows is awesome. Please, Bandai, make Master Grade. Master Grade is awesome, not High Grade. High Grade is suck balls. High Grade sucks balls. Zaza is quite cool as well. Of course, the Rosenzulu is also cool, but I think the color for this one is not purple, and another purple is more of a brown. This one is the Episode 7 version. Oh, this one is definitely the color purple. The other version of the yams, not to say it's the purple potato-like thing that is quite yummy, this one is definitely newer design and newer plastic, so it's purple. The first time that you saw the High Grade, they fucked up the color. So Dolan Wolf, this is the one that I have from Daban, I think, not sure which one. This one is the green version of the Dolan Wolf, and masala here. Dryson, it's a unicorn redesign of the what they call, shit, what's the name of it? The Dom. Yep, redesign of the Dom. This is a High Grade. It's quite heavy, so a lot of plastic in it. Of course, you should expect that because the leg here is a big, huge plastic. The Juagu looks nice, but looks silly, like an elephant. So a lot of High Grades here. The Thunderbolt, the OVAs, I think 4 episodes so far. Wow, quite heavy for High Grade. There's a lot of stuff inside there, a lot of bits to put together. I don't know, like the High Grade and the anime is a bit too realistic and actually too depressing. The Wave here, Wave is actually, I think it's like the Zaku 1. Ooh, what's this? Never seen this before. Ah, the Dom. Looks great actually. Origin Dom. Guess what? Episode 2 and Episode 3 of this Origin, don't see any Dom at all. How come they are making kits ready for something that is not shown in the anime or the movie? This one looks okay, this worker thing. Quite cool, it's 3:30 now. Make sure that I leave this place before the rush hour, before everybody goes back home, because that would be a nightmare on the streets. Goof, whatever, Zhong, High Grade, even though it's High Grade, it's huge. And as if my girlfriend would say, or my pretend girlfriend would say, even though your dick is not hard, it's quite big. It's an old Freedom Gundam. I have one still at home, not built yet, courtesy of my friend Hans. Can have that one if you want to. Phew. Master Grade Zhong. Jesta here. A lot of people love this kit actually. It's quite heavy too. Nice, a lot of parts in it. There's a Guzion. Whoosh! Oh yeah. This one is huge actually. Holy shit. The box is huge. My god. It's almost the same size as the Full Armor Unicorn Master Grade box. Holy shit, it's huge. You might be thinking that there are two Gundams in it, this one and this one, but no, it's actually just one inner frame, which you can choose to either have it in that one or the other one. So Bandai should just half the price and make it into two. So this one, the DJ, looks great. Aha, and the back here is the Nightingale. The Reborn, the first Reborn. It's only 479 ringgit. So after discount is $200 and $30. $230 for a big box. It's not bad actually. $230. But it's a big unit. Bloody big. Let's see here. Actually, it's quite interesting. Let's do the calculation for this Nightingale big box. Where is the yen? Is it here? No idea actually. Is it this one? No idea. God damn it, it's been obscured by the Bandai logo or sticker. Can't tell how much. 80,000 yen. It cannot be that cheap, right? It's like $80. $80. No. To Malaysian will be times 3. 8, 16, 24. $240. ringgit. 8,000 yen. Are you sure it's that cheap? 8,000 yen. This one is 3,500 yen. So $35 ish. This is like double the price of this. On double, this one was $70. This one is $80. So yeah, $200 plus. So it's roughly the same. So it's not really a steal. I wouldn't mind stealing it, but paying for it not so much. The real grades. It's too small. Don't like it. No idea. Zagog. Master grades. I would love to do this one. This one is if I can get it for 50 ringgit, then I'll be surprised. I'll be okay with it. But this one is about 160 ringgit. Aegis. This is Strike. So I love this one. This one looks great actually. 150 ringgit. This is Blitz. Blitz is actually very slim, you know, the size of the... It's very big, but the height-wise it's not that big. 110 ringgit. This one also... No, this one... Wait. This is cheaper. The Blitz is cheaper than the Buster. Why? I already have the Galgook, courtesy of Model Land Workshop in Penang, near that. Just go and Google Model Land Workshop. Awesome place. It's like a museum, lots of kids to see. They gave me one of these Galgooks, and it's about $130 offer here. And I did not get the chance to buy a TT Hongli of this one because I was too late. Somebody else bought it, motherfucker. I think it was supposed to be in Union 8. Oh, this Master Grade Double Zeta. Or is it one single Zeta? Single Zeta, I like it. I like the design. It's very slim, very nice. The Double Zeta is too big. I don't like it. Okay, what else is there? Sinanju Stein, I like it, of course. Lovely. About $500 here, but that means half price, $250. This one is the gold one, gold coating Phoenix. Very expensive, $790. Because of the gold coating. Very expensive. This one is the Hainyu Master Grade. Very, very nice. Like the design. I already have the other version, the new 2. It's a third party version. This is $500, 250 ringgit. This one is Gundam Origin. This is, so far, currently, a lot of people say that this is the best RX-78-2 currently. And is there a good price to this thing here? For about $50, $150 ringgit, I think. Yep, roughly the same. This one half of 314 ringgit is 150 plus plus. Not so much plus plus, but I think you get the general idea that the 40% here is not really that astounding. Indeed. Unless there's a typo in the machine or the price tag, then maybe you get a steal. But so far, No. My best bet for an affordable Gundam build is from China. There's a 7 sword, done that already from Daban, great stuff. Double riser from Daban, good stuff as well. I think I bought it for 60 ringgit or 50 ringgit, I'm not sure. About 55 ringgit each. So let's see, can't get a chance. I would have bought it 2 days ago, but as I said earlier, you build this, I mean, you build this one and this one is similar to this one. Except for this one, there's an armor separation. No! There are no armor separation. This one, it's only on the wheel grade, is it? Nope. There's an armor separation for the thigh. This white part here is separating when it's bending its knee. So, yep, it's mostly similar to the wheel grade. So, this one here, I love this design actually. This one here, Victory Gundam. I like it. It's very simple and very slimline. Very nice design. Very like it. I very like it. It's such a word or such a thing as, or such a sentence as very like it. I need water actually. Exia Dark Matter, very nice. I like it. A lot of things I like. Oh, this one you better not buy because this is all new too. Buy the worker version, the fat one. This one is not that fat. The newer one is fatter. But how much is the price? 419, that's 200 ringgit. This one here, this Gundam Wings, forget about it, it's a bit too small. I don't like it. Even though it's 1 out of 100 skill, but the design of the robots for the Gundam Wing universe is a bit smaller. I'm not sure why. This one I don't have the master grade, but I have the perfect grade pearl version. It does not come with decals at all. Stupid design. I had to scrounge the decals from other kits to make it more awesome and viewable or pretty instead of an ugly looking thing. This is a no grades, 1 out of 100 skills. So look, there are so many kits that needs a master grade or a reborn. So many. And they are all currently the best thing that you can get is the no grade version. These are the high grade 1 out of 100 skill, I figure. The Death Sai, which you can get the master grade version, you don't need to get this one. This is a high grade 1 out of 100 skill. Yes, you are confused with the high grades. You think there is 1 out of 144 skill, but back then, a long time ago, high grades are also 1 out of 100 skill. This one is a Hailbuster Gundam. At least you get different designs, you know. It's quite nice. No grade. No grade is quite nice. The Unicorn. 1,400 bucks. Half price. Roughly 700 to 800 ringgit. As I said earlier, this one is the 1,000 ringgit for the titanium finish of the Master Grade work car. New Gundam. Lovely indeed. Lovely, but I pokai, no money. The fat one, see, work car. High new, fat one. Venice. And of course here is the high grade and the full burst there. And I like this one, the design of this one. The Bill Fighters, I think this is the only Bill Fighters that I like besides the Goof. This one is nice. I like the shield, the small shield is very cute. Very cute indeed. Wing wheel grades and this one, the MK3. 105 bucks. I think it's quite a good deal, maybe 3500 yen times 3 should be 105 ringgit. Okay, it's the same. So what else is there? Unicorn 10148 skill. This one I'm very interested in, but it's 600 ringgit. Let's see here, made in 2002 in Japan, of course, not in China. And it's 15,000 yen, okay? 15,000 yen. That's roughly about 150 ringgit, I mean 150 US dollars times 3 back then, the currency is about 400. No, no, it's about 3 times 450 bucks. $450 back then, but now it's about $600. Depressing. Depressing that it's not cheap. But never mind. It's not a main thing here. And this one is the Goof Master Grade, I think. Nice. This is the mass, not the custom one from the OFMS Team OVA, but the regular version. Very nice. Quite nice. So I think that's about it. This is the review of the place. Nice figures, very nice. You can see them. And of course, highlight of the day would be the people who won the Gundam Bill, whatever, GWBC or something like that, I'm not sure. So hopefully you enjoyed the video. Like, subscribe, share it with your friends. Shout to the world that I'm the best person to have sex with. If you are a girl, say that I have an 8-inch cock, please. And yeah, see you in the next video. Help me in supporting me. Help me to make the next video by supporting me through Patreon or send some Gundam kits to me to Bill. Thank you very much, and see ya. So let's see here, the backside of the unit. Very nice indeed. Thank you, guys. Thank you. So now let's back to the review of this mall by the name of